Now, I've got this little tester. Here we are. Right. And with any luck, the audience might have some bubble wrap too. They're waving their bubble wrap. Thank you, audience. Do not pop it. This is a really important exercise.
So what do you mean, don't pop it?
Don't pop it. Do not. No. This is really important.
Okay.
No problem.
This is a test of your worthiness. Don't pop it yet.
One of mine's already popped. I didn't do it.
No, that's all right. As long as you didn't. Because in 2013, a group of Yale psychologists, they found another use for bubble wrap, which was to measure aggression. All right? They showed pictures of cute animals, all right? And
Wait.
Oh, stop it. People were told to pop bubble wrap as they watched. They thought that it was a test for their motor activity and memory. But in fact, it was a test for what's called cute aggression. If you see something very cute, you start popping more and more. Not because they wanted to hurt the animals, but because they were frustrated at not being able to touch them and cuddle them. And this is called cute aggression. It's when you kind of go, oh, like that. So, audience, hold your bubble wrap. We're going to show you some very cute animals, and it's all up to you.
Okay.
Let's start with the cuteness.
Oh, dear.
That's not that cute.
It's kind of dead.
He's not that cute. I think he's been shot.
That's horrible.
He does look like he's been shot.
Oh, the blue-eyed
Not that cute. Not worth a pop.
Yeah, that's getting quite a few pop.
Look at his little eye.
No, I'm not done yet. I want a dog, and then I'm going to pop my load.
That's the first time I've heard that phrase since last night.
Oh, the...
That's pretty cute.
That was the last one.
He's not cute. Ginger.
All right. You can put away your bubble wrap now.
That kitten is basically saying, help me, they're about to close the lid on this box.
He's probably the Schrodinger's cat.
Yeah, he is. I'm not going to exist in a minute.
Yeah. You may like to know that the last Monday in January is Bubble Wrap Awareness Day.
Oh,
it's the appreciation of Bubble Wrap
That's
Day.
In my
I'm
diary.
Sure they have a website.
Yeah.
They must do.
And Rhett Allain of Wired magazine calculated that you need to wrap yourself in 39 layers of bubble wrap in order to survive falling out a six-floor window. Mm. Oh, please don't try that at home.
Because you don't have a six-story house?
Maybe that.
So, if you wrapped yourself in bubble wrap six times, you could jump out of a building and you'd be...
No, 39 36.
Times.
39. Oh, thank God, we clarified.
Yeah.
So you're going to go up to the sixth story of your house? Yes.
I'm going up to the 39th story and wrapping myself six times. By my calculations, I should be fine.